Analysts say the prospect that Mohamed Morsi could be Egypt's next president might be unsettling to the U.S. and its allies.
In person, he's quite hostile towards Westerners and consistently says that he wants Egypt to be an Islamic state and has very unpleasant things to say about key American interests, including the treaty with Israel.
Eric Traeger was in Egypt during the Arab Spring and has interviewed Mohamed Morsi. He says Morsi wouldn't rip up Egypt's treaty with Israel, but would take a harder line toward Israel than Mubarak did. Traeger says Morsi and the Muslim Brotherhood want to implement Sharia law in Egypt.
The Brotherhood has indicated that they won't force women to wear the veil or the hijab, but what we've seen in Parliament is the Brotherhood is trying to, first of all, roll back the laws against sexual harassment, which they've said is due to women's nakedness, and secondly, they've tried to repeal the ban on female genital mutilation.
Traeger says Morsi and the Brotherhood see that ban as an intervention in the family. A Muslim Brotherhood ally of Morsi's responded.
Do you yourself believe that? Is there any democracy will allow this to happen? We're totally against this. We've had women's rights in Islam has been there for 1,400 years. We're not talking about a new civilization.
Abdul Malgud Dardari says Morsi, who got a Ph.D. in engineering at USC and has two children with American citizenship, wants to build bridges with the U.S. But there are questions about some of his allies. In this video clip of one of Morsi's rallies, a cleric named Safwat el-Higazi calls for a Muslim superstate with Jerusalem as its capital and says Morsi will lead them there. And analysts say Morsi, like other Egyptian leaders before him, has also pledged to work for the release of Omar Abdel Rahman, the so-called blind sheikh, serving a life sentence in the U.S. for plotting the unsuccessful 1993 terrorist attack on the World Trade Center.
You see, we would like to look at it as a legal case. If this man has legal rights, it is his rights, and we're going to support legal rights everywhere in the world.
I asked Traeger a bottom-line question for Westerners about Mohamed Morsi.
Under his leadership, Egypt is the next Iran?
We might not have an Iran per se. We're more likely to have a Pakistan in which a strong military intervenes in a radical political sphere at will.
I put that to Morsi's ally as well. Abdulmalgud Dardari says if Morsi wins, Egypt won't be like Pakistan or Iran.
Dardari says they won't move toward being a theocratic government, that Sharia law isn't scary as many Westerners believe. And he says we shouldn't be listening to people he called Islamophobes who are warning about what Egypt would be like under Mohamed Morsi. Brian Todd, CNN, Washington.